Jessica, first it's important to explain what exactly impeachment means. It does not mean the president is booted from office. Think of it like any other criminal case. Impeachment basically means the House of Representatives is bringing charges against the president, then it's the Senate's job to hold a trial and decide whether they will convict or remove the president. Now, just two presidents have been impeached before, the first being Andrew Johnson in 1868. He was not convicted by the Senate, so he was not removed from office, similar to Bill Clinton in 1998. Now, some might think that Richard Nixon was impeached. He actually wasn't. He was on track to be impeached and removed, but he resigned before any of that could happen. Now, President Trump could be charged today with abuse and power and obstructing Congress, but most experts believe it's unlikely the Senate will remove him from office.
A historic day, because for the third time ever, a U.S. president is expected to be impeached. The House of Representatives expected to approve two articles of impeachment tonight, abuse of power and obstructing Congress.
If I had to put odds on it, I'd put it at about 20%, meaning that it's not good odds, but it's possible.
Most experts, including Bakersfield College political science professor Alan Bowler, think it's a long shot that Trump will actually be removed from the Oval Office if he's impeached. That's because it will then be in the Republican-led Senate's hands to decide whether to convict and remove him.
I don't yet see that happening, and so that's why I would put the odds pretty low.
Representatives from both sides of the aisle spending the morning in debate.
Trump invited foreign interests to interfere in our elections for his personal gain, and he then took unprecedented efforts to cover it up, obstructing Congress.
It's a sham, a witch hunt, and is tantamount to a coup against the duly elected president of the United States.
President Trump tweeting in all caps this morning, "Such atrocious lies by the radical left do nothing Democrats. This is an assault on America and an assault on the Republican Party." Representative Kevin McCarthy also posting a video on Twitter last night calling out Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi.
Her conference will be smaller, the support will be less, and her legacy will be an embarrassment.
And what about Trump's legacy? Will a potential impeachment change voters' perception of him? Bowler doesn't think so.
I tend to think it's going to be less important than probably most people think, simply for the reason that we're almost still a year away from the election. And most things that are a year away tend to get a little bit forgotten.
Now, Bowler says things like the economy, healthcare, and immigration are going to be at the top of people's minds come November.
Now, let's say that they do vote to remove President Trump. Will he hypothetically be able to run for president in 2020?
That's actually up to the Senate. So the Senate has the option to make it so that Trump can be removed from office, and then they can add the stipulation that he's not able to run for public office again. Ann Bowler tells me that if he is removed this time, that's likely what's going to happen.
Wow. All right, Austin, thanks for that.